The cost for camp goes up, and if you've ever tried to run any kind of a program and feed people and put them up and take care of those things, you realize how much it costs every single day to take care of something. And so our ranch trip, I know for our teenagers, is about $350 for us to get them there and do some activities and things on the way, and the ranch gets a part of that. But they allow teen deaf campers to come absolutely free of charge, and it's always been that way as far as I know at the Bill Rice Ranch. There are a couple things I appreciate about the ministry. One is the deaf camp, the deaf ministry. I believe it's almost 100% when somebody comes lost to the ranch, a deaf camper comes to the ranch. The ones that I've met that are lost have all gotten saved when they're at the ranch. They have a week of dedicated preaching, and by Friday, here's a young person. Someone was burdened enough to just take to a deaf camp, and by the end of the week, they've come to Christ. And then you see them come back every year, and you see their lives change and see them growing. And what a wonderful blessing that is. Something else I appreciate is that the ranch has been in revival ministry, that particular ministry, for over 60 years. And Dr. Bill's been there, what, 30 of them or something like that? People change so much. In my lifetime, I have seen so many people change. And I don't believe the Bill Rice Ranch has ever changed. It's the same kind of a ministry, same foundation, same principle. And I don't mean they're stuck in, you hear the old paths, the old-time religion, and that means different things to different people. They're not stuck in yesteryear. They're not riding horses and carriages and that sort of thing. But they're doing ministry exactly the same. They have the same standards, the same Bible, and the same kind of preaching. And I never wonder what's going to happen. I can actually trust the pulpit at the Bill Rice Ranch, and it doesn't change. And so it's one of the things that I appreciate about that ministry. We're really honored to have Dr. Bill here and have him preach for us today, and Tim as well. I hope you enjoyed Sunday school this morning. If you weren't able to make it for Sunday school, make sure to get a copy of it. It'll be a blessing and a help to you as well. This morning, as you give in the offering, let me say a couple things about it. First of all, this is usually when I welcome our visitors. If you're visiting with us today, let me just tell you how delighted I am to have you here. Today we have Pastor Tim Day from Winston-Salem, North Carolina. Brother, thank you for coming, you and your wife. What a blessing to have you here today, and we're honored that you've come. And we have some other, Kyle, you haven't been here in, what, 7 years?
Probably something? Like
5 or so. 5, whatever it is, and you brought your friend with you. And thank you so much, guys, for being here today. We're really honored to have you with us here this morning. And so I don't say just first of all to our visitors, sometimes when you visit a church like ours, maybe you wouldn't understand what the offering is. It's something, it's a little different, or maybe you think you understand the offering and it isn't what it actually is. A lot of times when I meet somebody, they talk to me. They haven't gone to church, but they talk to me about what they see on television. And I know what they're talking about. It's a little bit insane, some of the things that are done in the name of God and in the name of taking up an offering. And I want you to understand this morning what it is at Fort Lauderdale Baptist Church. First of all, there's a reason why we do take up an offering. And the real reason for it is the Bible says too. The Bible says on the first day of the week, let every man lay by him in store according as the Lord hath prospered him. And it's talking about a collection for doing ministry, for ministry to the saints. So that's the Bible way to take up, to collect, to do ministry. It costs money to do ministry, and that's how you do it. And you've never seen anyone from our church ever out on a street corner and standing in front of Walmart and asking some stranger that doesn't go to the church and doesn't know Jesus and to support this ministry. I believe a ministry that's worth supporting will be supported by the people that are there. So the first reason we do it is because it's the Bible commands. And second reason, it just makes sense. But if you're visiting with us here today, let me just ask that you would just today be our guest and do one thing for us. If you haven't received a bulletin yet, right now you can just raise your hand. I'd like you to, like everyone here that hasn't gotten a bulletin yet, to get one of those. And on the inside front cover of the, or on the right side of the bulletin, there's a place where you could fill out your visitor information. And if you wouldn't mind doing that, and on the back of it is even a place you could fill out some prayer requests, and just fill that out and place that in the offering plate when it comes by. And we'd be honored if you'd do that, and that'd be your part in the service this morning, because we believe the offering's for us. If you feel you'd like to worship the Lord through giving this morning, please feel invited to do so, but don't feel obligated to do so. We want everyone to understand that. And then for the folks that are in this church, we'd ask that as you give, you just do two things. First of all, we'd ask that you just give prayerfully. Pray about the needs of the Bill Rice Branch. Pray about the needs of Fort Lauderdale Baptist Church. And as you do that, what the Lord lays on your heart, and you know something else I pray for, I pray and ask God to just do something with me, for God to do something that I couldn't do. You ever prayed and asked God to allow you to do something by His grace? That's biblical giving. And so just pray and say, God, would you let me do this, or God, what would you have me to do? And just obey. If you'll do that, we'll have exactly what we need to help deaf campers to go to the Bill Rice Ranch for free every summer, and to take care of the needs of this ministry as well. Thank you so much for being here. Alex, if you'll come and take care of this morning's offering. And Alex, if you would ask the Lord's blessing, please.
Father in heaven, we thank you for your goodness to us. Thank you, Lord, that you're the same yesterday, today, and forever. Father, you're the same God that saves. Lord, I pray that today, if there's anyone here who's not saved, I pray that the gospel will be preached clearly. Lord, I pray for conviction.